6 million. What do you think that number is related to? The new price of the iPhone X? The amount of times you have rolled your eyes at that annoying friend? Or the price of the unseen Kim Kardashian selfie? Well, that refers to the liter of water we have wasted only on the ice bucket challenge. 16 billion. What do you think this one is related to? That's the amount of hectares we have damaged in the forest. That sums up to be 75% of it. Another one. 5.1 billion. Any thoughts on this? That's the number of people who will be facing water shortage as a daily challenge only by 2025. We all know that the population is rising. It has went from 4 to 7 billion in this past 50 years. In the next 50 years, it's most probably gonna rise up to 10 billion, possibly more. So as the population is rising, we're gonna need more food, water, and space. Where are we gonna get it from? The Earth? But a better question is, how long can we survive on Earth? Or better said, how long can the Earth survive us? In 2016, Stephen Hawking said we only have 1,000 years left on Earth. In 2017, he cut it down to 100 years till what he calls the doomsday. We're damaging the Earth so fast we're not even realizing it. Since the Industrial Revolution, or even before that, we have been using Earth to provide what we want. We have used the air to breathe, we have used the trees to build shelter over our heads, and we have used the land to harvest, nurture, and to feed. But then we realized how much power humanity has, so we started doing more, using more. We created amazing paths that no humankind ever thought of reaching. We developed a technology that improves our lives. We traveled to the moon, we built electronical devices, we mastered flights and built vehicles. We done what was beyond imagination. But while as useful and amazing these achievements were, as we started doing more things that made our lives better, we started using more resources, some that we could never take back. One of the things that concerns me the most is what's happening to the poles right now. The North Pole's ice cap is melting. It has lost 40% of its thickness in 40 years. It's shrinking more every year. Scientists believe that it could all disappear before the summer of 2030. Some even believe sooner. Somewhere else in Greenland, the ice is melting fast. The damage caused by the Industrial Revolution, especially because of the greenhouse gases. It has made the ice cap melt in a speed that even the most pessimist scientists wouldn't have predicted 10 years ago. The sea levels are rising. Just along the 20th century, 20 centimeters has been added to the oceans. If all the Greenland ice melts, the ocean's gonna rise up to 7 meters. What will major coastline cities do? Dubai, New York, Hong Kong, Sydney? 70% of the world's population will be in danger, something that we cannot ignore. By our actions, we have created something that we cannot control. The sooner we accept it, the sooner we can walk towards making good right. And not by finding a new spot, or a new underground water, or a new planet to damage. In 21st century, which is known to be the greatest to provide your needs, 5,000 people per day die because of unpurified water. 844 million people don't even have access to safe drinking water. 824 million people are suffering from hunger. That's almost 12% of the world's population. The solution for the future? Nobody knows yet. But everybody wants to live in a better place. Everyone wants to live in a better environment. The only your actions not only ruin your life, but affect others too. While you're listening, think of how much water you left open when you were looking for your toothbrush and toothpaste last night. Or think of how many lights you left on from the room you were using this morning. Or even how many clothes you bought but you never used but still too stubborn to give away. These are the very basic steps that we all know, but rarely act upon. There is enough food, there is enough water and enough facilities for 7 million people in this world. But we're not using it right, we're not sharing it right. We need to take a step and actually help. Why don't we do it? Why don't you share your food with a homeless person or even provide a roof over their head? Why would you want to let them freeze till the morning? Our population is increasing by seconds. Around 170 babies are born every minute. As a member of the new generation, I don't want to live in a world when everybody's starting to think about moving to Mars. I don't want to live in a world when people are dying because of hunger. And I'm sick and tired of hearing that we have water problems when around 1,000 liters of water is being spent every day per person in Las Vegas. 7 billion people, 7 billion souls, and 7 billion lives living on the same planet with you. All lives are linked together. We're linked to the air, to water, to sun, especially to the earth. The earth might be too damaged to fix now, but as that simple quote said by Stephen Hawking, where there's life, there's hope.